Dear colleagues, today we are meeting here to discuss the readiness of the crew, and we need to state that the training has been accomplished fully, and we'd like to wrap up the results. Let us introduce the crew. The prime crew consists of Oleg Kononenko, FE of the Soyuz vehicle and FE of the station, Mr. Kimiya Yuri, representing Japanese Space Agency. Another board engineer is Kjell Lindgren, the United States of America. The backup crew consists of the commander Yuri Malenchenko, as well as Timothy Kopra, and representing the NASA, and Timothy Peake, representing European Space Agency. Please, your questions for the crew. TASS Agency, congratulations to you for completing the training. We wanted to ask Mr. Kononenko, it's going to be your third expedition. What are the plans for the third mission? Maybe you will pursue some tasks that you set for yourself during the second expedition. And what would you use as the dedication for this flight? You're quite right. This is going to be the third flight. Third flight of mine, but for the third time, I'm flying for the first time. That's the peculiarity. Although twice, for instance, I have gotten on the station using the expedited four-orbit rendezvous and docking. Now it's going to be different. So, which is to say that every time you fly, something is different. So I have put together a certain plan for myself. We have a very sophisticated, very well-designed program, very busy program. And to some extent, it's going to be the continuation of what we have started during the previous missions. This whole situation is developing in light of the mishap that we have experienced previously with the Progress vehicle, and we do have some obstacles and shortcomings associated with this mishap relative to our ability to continue the implementation of the space programs, particularly Russian space program. But in any event, I'm very much interested. I'd like to refer your attention to the booklet that outlines the set of experiments that I am expected to fulfill, to implement. So I'd like to draw your attention to the joint Russian-German experiment, which would allow us to further develop the internet capabilities. So I would like to be involved in this experiment, and I will have a chance to go and test the efficiency of the resources that we will have on the station as far as our ability to use the resources of internet. Another experiment has to do with the capabilities of the manipulator, of the robotics arm, which is also very important. Some other experiments will be dedicated to work out the ability to remotely control the functionality of the International Station or any other spacecraft, for that matter. Plasma crystal will be continued on orbit, which we have been doing for a long time, which is basically an investigation of the behavior of crystals under different circumstances and different conditions. This is interesting for me personally. Also, Uragan which is something that I'm a very big fan of. This experiment allows us to further improve our understanding of the mechanisms of all kinds of catastrophes that happen on the ground, earthquakes, hurricanes, tornadoes, and such. So there will be a number of new experiments. And we all know that in the zero-G, the way the blood is distributed inside of a human body becomes different. It becomes a little more chaotic. And we are in a position here to further improve our understanding of how to control this development and how to, for instance, help crew members with any kind of medicine that a crew member may require during their flight. Also, experiment bar, I would like to point out. This experiment is going to allow us to actually find all kinds of minimal leakages that may occur on this station. And I'm planning to use my spare time in order to conduct several experiments that have been suggested by the youth of the Russian Federation, students, school boys and girls, and also students of the universities of the Russian Federation. They have very bright ideas. And some of those are rather simplistic experiments, but anyway, I'd be more than happy to allocate some time to help the Russian youth to get some results on those. Thank you very much. More questions? Oleg gave us a very interesting story on the experiments that will be implemented on board. But we would like to listen to what the rest of the crew has to say on that. Mr. Yui, what exactly do you have in mind when it comes to your participation in the experimental work? I understand it's very interesting to be in a zero-G environment. The main goal for me is to assist in the research work, but I will attempt to actually conduct some research relative to improving and furthering the capabilities of the Japanese spacecraft called HTV. And I'm hoping that we will use our common resources and conduct very meaningful work on board. I'm very much looking forward to our future experimental activities on board. I'm sure I will get as much help as I would need. And I'm very glad that I'm having this opportunity. And I would pretty much echo the commander and say that we are very fond of what we are supposed to do. You may have seen in the internet the information which is dedicated to Expedition 45 and what we're doing there. We're just trying to impersonate the characters of Star Wars, which is very interesting. So what is it going to be?
So as Alex said, we made the Star Wars poster very popular for our expedition poster. And many of the spaceships in the movie have an R2-D2 droid or robot.
И как вам известно, в этом фильме на борту многих космических кораблей присутствует робот-астромеханик R2.
And so I was talking with my kids, and we decided that we should have an R2-D2 in our spaceship as well.
Я разговаривал со своими детьми, и они привели меня к мысли о том, что на нашем корабле «Союз» обязательно тоже должен присутствовать такой робот.
Спасибо.
Вопрос такой.
You've been trying to get ready for this flight both at GCTC in Russia and at Johnson Space Center in Houston. Could you, Mr. Lindgren and Mr. Yuri, compare the level of readiness that you have acquired at both space centers? And what was peculiar about the way you've been trained at both training centers? If you want us to compare, it's equally difficult to get trained at either centers. But it's equally pleasant as well. Because we deal with very reliable personnel, very knowledgeable personnel, and we get just completely sufficient training. And it's a great honor, actually, to have a chance to go and get trained at those two famous facilities. And we'll do everything we can in order to produce reasonable, meaningful results during the flight and get ready for our future endeavors in outer space. So we have done a lot of prelim work at JSC while trying to better understand the specifics of the United States segment. And we were trying to get ready to go and perform EVA tasks, which is an essential part of our activities in space. So it's, as you know, EVA is always a very beautiful and very magnificent event, and we have got to be prepared to actually perform those in the most appropriate way. It's difficult, but I like it.
Of course, the biggest difference between training here and in America and the other training sites is the equipment that we're training on. In America, of course, we train on the American segment of the U.S. segment of the space station, and here we're training on the Russian segment as well as in the Soyuz. In America also, we train using the American system for spacewalks as well as using the robotic arm to accomplish tasks and capture the visiting vehicles. And so while the training is different, there are some similarities, and of course, at both sites and around the world at all of our training sites, we get to work with some of the smartest and most dedicated professionals and trainers in the world. And so we were very grateful to get to work with such people.
Вот вы упомянули, что вы являетесь поклонником саги «Звездные войны», а в скором времени выйдет фильм «Марсианин», тоже космическую тему, и в сети появился трейлер, и уже многие космонавты и астронавты написали
в своей... find out what is your take on the way, on the gear that you're going to be wearing during the actual flight compared to what the characters of Star Wars usually wear. Yeah, I've seen some materials, some footage relative to the upcoming Star Wars project. And every time I see anything like that, I get so much inspired, I cannot even express it. Just a magnificent effort, it's just so breathtaking activities and events that are going to be depicted during this movie, it's just completely mind-blowing.
Of course, I'm a big fan of the Star Wars movie and looking forward to seeing the Martian movie and what technology they are using in that film.
Являюсь большим поклонником фильма «Звездные войны». Я с нетерпением жду вас, когда мне представится возможность посмотреть фильм «Масянин», посмотреть, какое оборудование применяется в данном фильме.
But that is science fiction, and while it helps us to dream of what is possible, what is reality is that 40 years ago we had a partnership of Apollo and Soyuz in that docking, which really opened the door to set the foundation for what we are doing today as an international partnership on the International Space Station.
Этот фильм является научной фантастикой, поэтому нельзя судить его строго. 40 лет тому назад у нас был замечательный пример сотрудничества российской стороны с американской стороной, полет Аполло, корабля Аполло Союз, который положил начало всему тому, что происходит сейчас.
And I hope that 40 years from now we can look back at what we are doing on the International Space Station and see this as the foundation for an incredible future partnership that maybe actually takes us to Mars.
Добрый день, телеканал 360 Подмосковья, Татьяна Пчелина. Вопрос к Челу. У вас первый опыт космического полета. Что вы ожидаете?
Mr. Lindgren, you have the first experience to fly, first opportunity to fly. What do you expect from this flight?
Well, of course, we have been preparing for many years for this flight. Together, we've been preparing for 2.5 years, and I'm very excited for this opportunity. For me, this is a dream come true.
Мы готовились вместе с моим экипажем в течение 2.5 лет, и я очень рад возможности полететь в космос, и я уже говорил неоднократно, что это осуществление моей давней мечты.
There are two things that I'm particularly looking forward to. One is looking through the window and looking back at our beautiful home planet, looking at the Earth. And the second is just learning how to truly live and work in space. It's wonderful to get the opportunity to be up there for 5 months and to truly adapt to the weightless environment.
Есть две вещи, которых я с нетерпением жду. Первое – это возможность выглянуть из иллюминатора космической станции, посмотреть на вид Земли сверху. И вторая – это научиться жить и работать на большой станции и приспособиться за 5 месяцев к НИСУ.
Олег, и к вам вопрос. У вас это уже третий полет.
Мистер Кононенко. This is the third flight that you're going to be flying. How difficult is it to part from the Earth, from your family, from everything that surrounds you on the ground? Well, we have a job to do, and this is something that I concentrate on. For my family, it's also always difficult not to see me for such a long time. I do have two kids, small kids of mine, and I mean, there's nobody who would go and play soccer with them, nobody who would go and stay close to them and take care of them while I'm flying. But this is something that comes along with the responsibility of flying in the outer space. When it comes to what I plan, I would like to conduct a lot of picture taking on orbit. And I'd like to use this opportunity to express my gratefulness to all those who helped to make my dream come true.
Насколько мы знаем, но последний раз уже используется инструкция, не бумажная, то есть планшет, да, корабль Союз. Это, ну, я не знаю, это удобно, какое ощущение использования планшет, ну,
It's inaudible. The heavy accent. I cannot understand what the person is saying.
No, это еще, я думаю, это эксперименты, поэтому бумаги не основной, поэтому я работаю.
So like we said before, we are going to conduct a lot of experiments. Those experiments I prioritize, and I will concentrate on being able to perform everything I can to make this happen. And this is going to be done in the weightless environment, which will add compound, actually, complexity to the situation. The usage of the tablet is planned for the second time only. I'm going to be doing it for the second time, like I said. So in the future, I think there are plans in place to adapt the tablet to the actual environment, which has not been done as yet. But in the meantime, we're going to have to work the way it is right now. We know that electronics generally is developing very quickly, and we will hope that very soon this is going to happen. But as a backup option, we will use the tablet the way it is right now. Mr. Lindgren shared with us his desire to look through the window, take a look at the planet of Earth. But what particular region you would prefer to be watching? And do you have any particular ways of enhancing your capabilities to monitor the planet of Earth? And whether or not this is going to interfere with the rest of the crew? About a year ago, I came to know about the Geographic Society of the Russian Federation. They do have a lot of interesting projects, a lot of interesting materials. And I actually read about the contest, which actually gives an opportunity to depict Russia, the most beautiful parts of Russia. And I'm not planning to participate in this contest, but I have decided for myself that during my flight, I will be trying to put together a gallery of different snapshots of my motherland. We have an excellent commander, so all I have is just to follow in his steps and try to do the same thing as far as my country goes. But there is also a common goal. It is very important for us to be engaged in this kind of activity and make it successful. So people on the both on the ground and on the station would be able to share the results of our joint work. It is very important that we help each other.
I think that the thing that helps us to communicate the most is the fact that we've spent 2.5 years training together. We rely on our commander's tremendous experience and leadership, and I feel very fortunate to get to fly with Kimiya, who is a classmate of mine. We started Astronaut Canada training at the same time, and I've gotten to work with him extensively over the years.
Конечно же, мы полагаемся на опыт и на лидерские качества командира, и также я очень рад той возможности, что мне представилась возможность полететь вместе с Кимией в космос, потому что мы с ним проходили подготовку совместно на протяжении 6 лет.
So I think having that time, spending time training together, we come to know each other's reactions to situations, how we use the procedures, and how we work. And I know that my crewmates are very hard workers, and so I look forward to working with them on the space station.
И длительная совместная работа помогла нам лучше изучить реакции друг друга на происходящие ситуации во время тренировок. И также помогла нам узнать друг друга лучше.
Спасибо.
На продолжение этого разговора, пожалуйста, расскажите.
So to continue this discussion, please tell us, what professional qualities of each other you are prepared to indicate at this point? Tell us what the actual quality of the crew of the International Station is, which will spend many months on orbit. There is so much to say. We are very similar emotionally, professionally. It's just the mindset that is almost the same. And every now and then, people of my crew come up with the very unexpected and interesting ideas as to how to organize our work on orbit. And when we were in training in a Soyuz vehicle on the Russian segment on the USOS, crew members used to come up with all kinds of non-standard approaches to how this training should have been done. We also have a very good sense of humor, which comes in very handy during our tough training and preparation. So the ability to find the right word and to address each other is a great quality that we all share.
Again, like I said before, I feel very fortunate to get to fly with Oleg. He has a tremendous experience with his previous flights and with his having commanded before.
Как я уже отмечал, я невероятно рад тому, что мне посчастливилось оказаться в этом экипаже. У Олега есть невероятный опыт полетов в космос.
I think that he is, I find that he is very calm, very good at making decisions, as well as delegating work to Kimiya and I, so that we work effectively as a team.
Но поскольку он очень опытный, он очень быстро и грамотно принимает решения, и это помогает нам вместе с Кимией правильно и грамотно действовать в различных ситуациях.
And I've gotten to work with Kimiya since 2009, so over 5 years, almost 6 years now. We trained together quite a bit when we were astronaut candidates.
Что касается Кимии, то мы с ним работаем, начиная с 2009 года, уже почти на протяжении 6 лет.
He always has a positive attitude, and he's a very hard worker. And I know that we are very fortunate to have. I'm very fortunate to have both of these crewmates on this expedition.
Мия всегда позитивно смотрит на вещи, и он очень трудолюбивый член экипажа, поэтому я с нетерпением жду предстоящей возможности полететь с ними.
Да, так.
As Kjell said already, our commander is very experienced and always knowledgeable about what we're trying to accomplish. So he leads us always, he tells us what we need to do. And he's very calm, which is very important. It is important to fly in space being calm. So I'm very much grateful to become the member of this particular crew, because if we work hand in hand together, we will accomplish everything. It's very easy to find the common grounds with my crewmates, and I'm sure we'd be able to do a nice job on orbit.
Oleg Dmitriyevich, слышно, да?
Oleg, one more question for you. You're an engineer, so I'd like to ask you, as an engineer, there were two failures of the Progress vehicle over the course of the last 4 years. You, as an engineer, do you have any fears before the actual flight associated with possible potential failure? Well, I don't have a fear, a natural kind of wild fear. Everybody fears. Even if you are using the most reliable systems, you still will fear and should probably fear. We have a sophisticated escape system that will help us if anything goes wrong, but otherwise it's not fear, it's maybe just a concern. We are, and I am personally concerned that we should do a lot of work in order to accomplish the flight program. As for the technology that RSC Energia demonstrates, we totally rely on our people and on their capability to come up with a fine vehicle.
Я корреспондент японской газеты «Майн». Меня зовут Мано. Это вопрос к господину Юи-сан. Пожалуйста, вы неоднократно пишете в Твиттере, что...
You have been tweeting many times that you have spent more than any other Japanese cosmonauts or astronauts in Russia. And also that you have been helped very much while trying to get ready for this flight. I love Russia dearly. And this is true what you said. People here are very kind. And during the training, although it's just extremely difficult, a lot of people treated me in the best way possible. They're very kind to me. And I always felt here at home. It helps very much to overcome difficulties. They to work together. And quite frankly, I have visited the United States of America as well, and I like America as well. So there's no preferences. And I have a prominent career as a pilot, and this helped me tremendously in order to live up to the standards required for me to become a cosmonaut or astronaut. Your launch has been postponed because of the Progress mishap.
Of course, we were disappointed with the Progress of the 9P mishap and with the initial delay to our flight.
Поначалу, конечно же, мы расстроились, узнав о переносе нашего старта на более поздний срок в связи с катастрофой, произошедшей с прогрессом.
But of course, we're confident in the engineers' professionalism of the Russian space program, to identify the problems and to ensure that that problem does not exist with our spacecraft.
Мы доверяем всем конструкторам и инженерам, которые работают над обеспечением надежности нашего корабля, и надеемся, что такое не произойдет с нашим кораблем.
The time that we had during the delay has given us additional time for some refresher training, to spend time with our families and to rest.
Время, которое у нас появилось в связи с переносом старта, дало нам возможность побольше подготовиться, пообщаться с нашими семьями и немножко отдохнуть.
And so I think now we are ready to fly whenever the spacecraft is ready to take us in space.
И на сегодняшний день, я думаю, что мы готовы к полету, и в любой момент, когда проверка готовности систем будет завершена, мы сможем полететь.
Спасибо. Когда один день, я считаю, да, кто-то произошел, то это будет причина.
Well, something happened, and there must be a reason for that. I know that people will go and investigate the root causes of this problem. Which requires some time. As far as I'm concerned, I treat this situation as an extra opportunity to continue training, to improve my skills. And I never was concerned about anything. I know for a fact that everything possible has been done to assure our safety, and I also know that the Soyuz vehicle is the most reliable transportation system in the world. And we know that appropriate people will be trying to make sure that every precaution is being made to assure the safety of the crew.
Здравствуйте, Олег Дмитриевич. Хотела бы спросить, что из бытовых вещей самое сложное для МКС? Из того, что мы делаем каждый день, буквально не задумываемся об этом, там, пьем чай, чистим зубы.
What is the most difficult part for you to be on the International Space Station? Well, it's a matter of getting adjusted. Now, there are small things like hygiene, for instance, that you still have to adjust yourself to, because there's no water, but you still have to abide by certain rules, and to be able to do that is something that you need to learn. You all have many kids. What do your children know about the profession of their fathers? How many details do they have, do they know about the way your training was done? Well, my kids obviously know who I am. They will be seeing me off and will be expecting me on the ground impatiently, I'm sure. The launch is a very emotional scene, emotional event. After the second launch, they were actually scared. And the launch of the rocket did have an impact on them. Now they are a little bit older, so hopefully the effect is not going to be nearly as severe as it used to be.
I've had the opportunity to bring my wife and children to many of my training events in Houston.
У меня была возможность привести свою семью, свою жену, своих детей приводить на все тренировки в Хьюстоне.
And they've also gotten to see training here at Star City, and will be coming out to watch the launch as well.
Они сейчас также находятся здесь и наблюдают за моей подготовкой здесь, в Звездном городке, и они также приедут на Байконур, чтобы увидеть мой старт.
Very grateful for their support and grateful that I get to share this incredible adventure with them.
Я безгранично благодарен за их поддержку и за то, что они всегда рядом и всегда поддерживают меня, когда мне это необходимо.
I think my kids do understand who I am and what I'm expected to will be doing for quite some time on orbit. And I miss my family because I have to travel extensively. It's difficult, but my family does understand the specifics of being involved in an international space station activities, and I'm very much grateful to my family for that. And I hope that when they will be watching the launch, they will have very positive feelings about that. I'm sure they will.
2ヶ月乗りましたけれども、本当に今となっては本当に良かったかなと、先ほどのインタビューで言いましたけど、何か起こった時っていうのは何か良いことが起こるために起こったんだと私は解釈するようにしてるんで、2ヶ月間さらにトレーニングをすることができて、準備も万全に整ったので、あとは本当にこれまでの成果を上で出すしかないのかなと思ってます。出したいなと思ってます。
で、本当に国民の皆様方も期待というのも私感じてますので、ツイッターでですね、あとはニュースなどで感じてますので、しっかりと成果を残して、皆様方に、その成果を見せて、それが、で、安全に帰ってくることっていうのが、一番のお土産かなと思ってますので、そういうミッションにしたいと思ってます。So
the question was, how do you feel about the delay of the launch? And what I said was that there is a lot of people in Japan who are very much interested, and they are keeping an eye on the developments of this preparation for this flight. And I'm sure this is all done, this delay, it happens because of the safety concerns, and there will be no other consequences. The press conference is almost over. Let us ask questions of the backup crew. What are your plans as far as seeing your colleagues off? We know you're going to be right close to them.
We know that they're very well prepared for their flight. And I think they're all aware, especially Oleg, how special the opportunity is to fly in space. So I guess my advice is to treasure each day and look at it as a gift.
И мой совет – это воспринимать каждый день как дар и принять этот полет как клад, как сокровище.
We are backups, obviously, and our goal is to stand by the primary crew and to help them out in every aspect of preparation for the flight. So we will be supporting the prime crew, and at least we will try not to cause any trouble. So everything gets done strictly in accordance with the schedule, and hopefully the launch is going to be a big success.
The question was related to your colleagues. Do you have any wishes and words which can accompany them to the flight?
Just to reiterate what Tim and Yuri have said, really, and I wish them a very safe and successful mission. And I look forward to the prospect of actually sharing some time on board the space station with the prime crew when we do our handover in December. And as a new astronaut flying to the space station for the first time, I certainly look forward to learning from their experiences over the next 5 to 6 months.
And our goal as the prime crew, not only to accomplish everything that has been planned, but set up the stage for the crew of Yuri Malenchenko to come to the station later on and do a fine job in their turn. Thank you very much. Dear colleagues, we would like to state that the crews will wrap up their training on July the 10th, and then the crews will be traveling promptly to Baikonur. Thank you very much for your kind attention. Спасибо.